Janine, good morning.
Good morning,
Janine, good to see you.
Lily, nice to see you guys.
We dissect their words so much, but you're going to clue us into their body language because there's some tells there as well as to what kind of leader they would be,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, absolutely. We actually will look at body language more often than words. I'm a keynote speaker for big corporations,
yeah.
And they'll all have to hold hands, and I say, okay, these hula hoops are in the middle of their hands. I say, go in a circle. The hula hoops have to make their way in a circle. And then back in the circle. But I do this with my body,
yeah.
And I go, the hula hoops have to make their way around the circle. What do you think the executives do? They climb through the hula hoops. Mm. Because of this gesture, they will pay attention more to the gesture than to the words.
All right, so let's start by taking a look at Hillary Clinton. Let's play the sound and
I've always
tell us what
been
you
somebody
see.
Who believed and raised in my family and my faith that I, with my blessings, had an opportunity and obligation to do what I could to help others, and that's what I will do as president.
Now, let's rewind. You might not have even seen it.
Okay.
Did you see it?
No.
It's a shoulder shrug. Watch this. A shoulder shrug indicates uncertainty.
Let's my family and my faith.
Look at this. Watch here. We have one shrug already, two shrugs right here. We're going to have a third. There we go. We have the hat trick of shoulder shrugs right here. A shoulder shrug is uncertainty. So when you're saying a definitive answer, listen, I'm doing this not for me. I'm doing it for the public. And I shrug, it cancels out your message. A shoulder shrug is uncertainty. But if I've ever said to you, hey, Willie, did you ever cheat on your wife? And you say no, it doesn't mean you're a cheater. Maybe you know your neighbor is cheating.
Right.
So we don't know what the catalyst is here for Hillary, but it will hurt her message.
And you think voters pick up on those cues subconsciously?
Yes, subconsciously. Yeah. We do pick up on it. Our brain, it's called an N400. If I say I'll have a peanut butter and jelly on my socks, please, your brain says, wait a minute, I don't understand that. When you
it's
make
not
a definitive
sign of
statement,
humility, maybe, though?
No,
or,
it's always uncertainty. It's an emblem in the United States of America. This is, what do you want for lunch? I don't know. What do you want? I would love to be president.
Okay.
She's imploding here.
Wow.
Okay, let's take a look at Donald Trump. Of course, again, we heard a lot of what he's had to say. You read the body language. Tell me what you see.
People are buying it. You know what's happening. It's dead. It's going
to. I want you to watch his hands. Let's rewind.
He uses the hands a lot.
So I want you to rewind this. He does this move quite a bit. So let's rewind and watch Donald Trump's hands.
It's turned out to be a disaster. The wrong people are buying it. You know what's happening. It's dead. It's good.
You know, I always think of the monkey with the tambourines there or the cymbals. And I'm not saying it to disrespect Donald Trump. This move right here that he does constantly, remember that you wind up this toy and the monkey's like, ding, ding. He does this move constantly, this banging of his hands in the air.
And what does that tell you?
It is connected with people who think outside of the box, creative thinking. That's why you get someone that is from the real estate industry running for president. That's why you get a man who's going to be on the front lines talking to, the people coming into our border, border patrol. He's going to think outside the box, creative thinking. If you want someone that has that strategy with creativity, Donald Trump might be.